guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be honest with you and use my real voice. But also, because my mic is broken right now and I've got to stick with this, I suggest you use earphones or headphones, okay? And my computer speakers are broken anyway, so you know what? Let's just get on with the video. Today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make the thumbnails, and if you don't know what I mean is these. I mean, I've only made two so far, and I like them. They're not great, but I do like them. And yeah, they're just thumbnails, and I'm going to be teaching you how I make them. So the first thing you're going to need to download Sims 4, obviously, and paint.net, because I don't use Photoshop, because paint.net is easier, okay? And what you want to do is watch this whole video to understand, because if you put in what you need to put, which is 1282, and 720, yeah, it's a bit bigger. So you also need snipping tool, which you don't have to download. And yeah, I'll show you what you actually need to do that at the end. So first of all, what you're going to need to do is go on to Sims 4, and you need to download a green screen, guys. You need to download a green screen. Okay. And if you don't know how to do add a green screen to your game, then I will do a video on that as well. Okay. I will also do a video on how to make a green screen for you guys. Okay. But then, you want to download some poses for create a sim cast poses, because here, I don't know if I can Sims 4 cast poses, because yes, you need these as well, and you just need to press C, and when you're you need to give them the trait that it needs, and yeah, okay, yeah, I can't show you in this video because I can't do gameplay and thingy unless, but yeah, okay, right. And then what you want to do is open this, and if you have took the screenshots, it will be in Documents, Electronic Arts, Sims 4, and Screenshots. Here is where it will show up. Oops, subscribe, we don't want that. Let's try and look at these. Okay, right, my friend added one. I just want to see if I can, if I might add it to the, I don't have many green screen photos, because ones that I did a few days ago. But I'm just going to use my friend sim, okay, because I'm sure she will like that. So what you want to do is you want to press copy. Sorry, I've got a chest infection. So right click and press copy. And then on here, you want to what? To press. Control. And V at the same time, okay? And I'm just going to press back on that. The back tool is just up here. Wondering, I might need to make this a bit bigger soon. Right, control V, and then this will come up, and you want to keep the canvas size. Okay, so then here we go. Now, I actually started working on another thing, but oh well. Then you want to click this magic wand, and you want to click on this, the green bit, and you're going to click either delete or backspace. You want to do this with any other bits. Yeah. No. Try not to get rid of the skin. And you will notice that it is still in the hair a bit. Usually, depending on what hair you use, it will still be in the hair. And you, so all you need to do is get this, zoom into here. Okay, this bit takes longer, but it does get away the green. Oh god, I forgot to do something. Okay, guys, you can totally hate on me for doing this to you guys. Yeah. You had to add layer. Yeah. You have to do that. Sorry for wasting 5 minutes of your time. I will just get rid of the screen. Okay, guys, so I just tried to do it quickly. I didn't actually spend my time doing it, so if you notice any green, that's why. Also, once you're done, click this. Because, yes, it's going to take you to the original thing. Now, you want to get a background, which I search up mostly. Is Sims 4 City. Sometimes you put in background. Because as you will see, in the backgrounds of these, if you look close enough, you will see there's a city. So find one and copy it. So I may just use this one for quickness. Just copy the image, go back to paint. Now click this here and control V. You might have to make it a bit bigger. Yeah. So this is just basically the start. I might need to make this a part two because I can only do 10 minutes. So then what you want to do is come up here and do adjustments, brightness and that. And you could just think of your sim. You can mess about with the sim until you like it. Just mess around with the effects until you feel like you like it. There is something that I do suggest is saturation. Because for one of the effects I will teach you to do in a few seconds, saturation might have to be a little bit up. But you know. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to show you to do is press this. It's just a duplicate layer. And now, when you go here, click effects, photo, glow, put radius down, and these two up. And these then should be like this, and then just keep on repeating the glow until you're happy, and then if you do this, it's gonna have like a light effect behind your sim. There's something else that I do that is actually kind of cool is if you search up like another type of background, like something like this, and if you were to copy the image and add another layer. And then, V, keep the canvas size. Put it just above that layer. Double click it. And if you do this, kind of things in with the background, which is really cool. So yeah, I just keep on doing that with other things, because the more you do, the more cooler it looks, and I just get it until I'm happy. Sometimes I would use like watercolor transparent, and I just use other backgrounds and, you know, just details and that, you know, until, yeah. And I do the same that I just done with this background. So as you may see, I've added a few things in the background. Okay, now one of the best effects. Pick any sort of light flare you like. I personally always go with this one. Then if you put it behind your sim, make it a bit bigger, like this. And if you get this starburst transparent, put that behind your sim, and then it looks cool. And then after that, all I do is add the text. Sorry, I had to kind of speed this up because I'm only about 10 minutes on making a video. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I guess I'll see you in the next video. Good damn. Bye.